Now for the operation of the buck boost connector in open loop mode, we just need to shift our connections from here to here. Connections are same for the open loop mode, internally load fix connected at the output side. Okay, and just we need to change buck boost on display here and open loop mode. Now I am connecting my DSO on G3 pulse, so we can observe the G3 gel process. Now I will make my converter on. So by default 50% duty ratio is there, so we can show the duty ratio on DSO, 50% is there. And our output equation for the buck boost converter, so for the buck boost converter our output voltage will be D upon 1 minus D into Vin. In this case Vin fixed 20 volt as previously we said, and our duty ratio is 50%. So on 50% our output voltage will be same as the Vin voltage. So you can show the 20 or 21 volt here as same as the input side. Now I make duty ratio approximate 30%. So we will observe the our output voltage on 30%. So when we make the 30% duty ratio, as per the theory approximate 9 volt we will get at the output side. So on multimeter you can show the output voltage 9.3 volt and our duty ratio will be 30%. And as per the theory says the buck boost converter means above the 50% duty ratio our buck boost converter will be work as a boost converter. So now I am making my duty ratio is above the 50, means approximate 60%. Because maximum limit for the buck boost converter duty ratio is 60, and I will press the enter key. So you can show our duty ratio on DSO screen 60% turn on period, and as per the theory we will get a 30% output in buck boost converter on 60% duty ratio. So you can perform the buck boost converter from the range of 10 to 60% duty ratio, but above the 50% it work as a boost converter. So it's open loop mode in the buck boost converter.